my name's Emma, and I'm a huge book nerd.
You're my library, always open for business.
It has been a minute once again since my last wrap-up video, and I've been reading up a storm, so I have a lot of books to talk to you about. This is sort of a May, June, July wrap-up. The wrap-ups got away from me, man. I'll try to be a little more consistent going forward, but you know, I'm trying to keep YouTube fun this time and not stressing myself about it, so I hope that's working for you guys, because it's working better for me. I'm just gonna talk through the books that I've read since I last spoke to you. So the first book I wanna show you is Valentine by Elizabeth Wetmore. This book, man. So it takes place in 1976 in Odessa, Texas, in like it's a small town, like an oil town, I guess is what you would call it. Definitely trigger warning for sexual assault. The story starts with this young girl. This young girl is brutally raped, and much of the town doesn't believe that it happened because she is a Mexican girl, and the town is like incredibly racist, basically. The book is about the women in this town coming together to find justice for this girl, and it is a very difficult book, but a really powerful book, and I love a good female revenge story kind of deal, so this was definitely pretty great. I ended up giving it 4 stars. Okay, the next book I want to talk to you about is The Invention of Nature, Alexander von Humboldt's New World by Andrea Wolf. Oh my god, you guys. This book changed my life a little bit. I loved this book so much. It's a nonfiction book about Alexander von Humboldt, who was an explorer and nature scientist botanist in the very early 1800s. He heavily influenced so many areas of science. He was basically the first person who said, "Hey, guess what? The universe does not revolve around mankind. Mankind is a part of nature, and we have to not destroy Earth or we're all gonna die." And it was just, it's just incredible to hear how this person from the early 1800s was warning us about all the things we know now and had such a prolific influence in the arts and in science and in literature and just politics everywhere. He's so influential, it is nuts. The people in this book that you find out that he influenced, like Darwin and Simon Bolivar and like all of these people who we've heard about in history, and I've never heard of Alexander von Humboldt before. So highly, 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 highly recommend reading this book. Oh my gosh, so good. Just like my roommates wanted me to shut up so badly because I just kept like spewing facts about Alexander von Humboldt. Oh god, highly recommend. I have lent it to my dad right now, which is why I do not have it, but an incredible book. I obviously gave that one 5 stars. Next, I read a play. I read What I Did Last Summer by A.R. Gurney, and frankly, I remember basically nothing about this play. I remember it being about a young man, and it uses direct address a lot, and the use of direct address was really interesting. I wrote on Goodreads that I really liked the play, and I gave it 4 stars, but to be perfectly honest, I could not tell you what this is about. So, you know, if you like a good play, maybe pick that up, but it clearly wasn't that memorable, so. Next, I read Hex by Thomas Oldhelvold. Still can't pronounce the name. I'm so sorry. He's Dutch. I'm not gonna say much about this because I talk a lot about it in the last video that went up, the Stephen King Picks My TBR video. So if you're curious about what this is about or what I thought about it, go check out that video. Next, I read We Are All Completely Beside Ourselves by Karen Joy Fowler. I've had this book for a really long time. My old high school librarian recommended this book to me. I think I got a copy of it at Goodwill. I don't really remember, but I've had this for a really long time and I haven't read it until now, and I'm really glad that I picked it up because it's a really interesting read. This book is about a family who adopts a baby chimp to raise alongside their daughter. And it's really about the daughter once she's grown up and her life and struggling with the memories of her childhood and her relationship with her family. In my Goodreads review, I described it as weird and wonderful and a little bit heartbreaking, and I stand by that. I ended up giving it 4 stars. Next, I read Gravity by Tess Gerritsen, and again, I read this for that Stephen King video, so to hear my thoughts, head over there. Then I read In Cold Blood by Truman Capote, and I will say I struggled to get through this. I was really excited to read it. I thought it was going to be incredible. It's, if you don't know, it's sort of the first true crime nonfiction books to be written in that sort of creative nonfiction way that Anne Rule and Michelle McNamara and those folks write about true crime. I was really excited to read it, and to be honest, it was just kind of tough to get through. It was really repetitive, I feel like. I don't know. I can't say I'd recommend it. It was a slog. I ended up giving it 3 stars. Then I read another play. I read Middletown by Will Eno, and I didn't care for this one much, to be honest. It sort of had an almost Waiting for Godot kind of pointlessness to it, and it seems that that is in fact the point of the play. I just don't really care for that very much, so just not my cup of tea. I gave it 2 stars. Then I read The Lying Game by Ruth Ware, and I loved this. It was the best, at the time, it was the best thriller that I had read in a while, and it got me excited about thrillers again, and excited about Ruth Ware in general. This is the first Ruth Ware that I have read, and I must say, I'm excited to read much more. I gave this a whopping 5 stars. Next, I read Sing, Unburied, Sing by Jessamine Ward. I have had this on my shelf for a while. I'd never gotten around to it, and I really, really need to be reading more books by Black authors. And so I looked at, you know, what I already had on my shelf and started picking from there first, and this is what I picked up. And let me tell you, this book is something really special. It's this incredible ghost story that doesn't feel at all like any other ghost story I've ever read. It turns your stomach and brings tears to your eyes, makes you feel all kinds of frustrated, and it's, the writing is just poetry. It's gorgeous, like just so beautiful. Would highly, highly recommend picking this up. I gave it a whopping 5 stars. Next, I read Letter to My Daughter by Maya Angelou. And this is basically just a collection of short letters to women in general, because Maya Angelou doesn't have a daughter, but she writes to all of us as if we are her daughter. And it's really lovely. There's some really lovely advice in here, and it's certainly very inspiring. I'm not usually one for these sort of like advice books. Tumnus, can you? Your tail is being distracting. I apologize for Tumnus's tail. But yeah, I'm not usually one for this sort of advice column kind of book, but I thought it was really nice, and there's some good stuff in here for sure. I ended up giving this 4 stars. Then I read The Knockout Queen by Ruphie Thorpe, and this book took me by surprise. It's about this boy, Michael, who's gay and not publicly out, and his best friend Bunny, who's a very tall woman, as they go through high school. It's about their friendship, it's about their struggles with their own self-confidence, and this book was a lot heavier than I expected, I will say. I heard, you know, high schoolers, and I was like, oh, a fun summer read. It's not a fun summer read. Let me just put that out there first and foremost. It tackles some really, really tough questions, but it does so excellently. I think this book was phenomenal and a great read for Pride Month. I gave it a grand old 5 stars. Next, I read Thick and Other Essays by Tressie McMillan Cottam. Why is this name hard for me to say? Tressie McMillan Cottam. This is a collection of essays addressing beauty standards, systematic racism, classism, all of those things, and feminism. And I will say it's incredibly informative and really challenging in many ways. The ideas she presents are at times challenging and super important to listen to. I would like to say that. Please, please don't dismiss the ideas. Listen to them and take them in and think about them. But it's also challenging in that I like literally had to have a dictionary and a pen and paper with me reading this. She does not dumb anything down at all. It's a denser read than I was expecting from like a collection of essays. Absolutely worthwhile. Just be prepared to turn your brain on. I gave this 5 stars and I highly recommend you read it or something like it. The next book I read was How to Talk About Race by Ijeoma Oluo. And again, I don't have this copy with me. I left it at home with my family for them to read. But I would highly recommend starting with this book if you are confused by what's going on or you don't really know anything about systematic racism or you're just like, I don't get this. I really don't know what's happening. This would be a great place to start. It sort of gives a more broad overview of everything with lots of really helpful specific examples as well. And then it also gives recommendations for books you can read or essays you can read or resources you can use to dig deeper. But it is an excellent starting point, and it tackles a lot of the sort of commonly asked questions or common arguments that you might encounter. So I would definitely recommend starting here if you need to start kind of from the beginning, which a lot of us do. You know, you need to re-educate from the start. I do also want to say I'm not the first place you should come for recommendations for anti-racist books, because you know, I'm a white woman, I am learning myself, and there are plenty of Black BookTubers who have videos recommending anti-racist books. I will find a couple of those and link them in the description if you want some specific recommendations on that. I just wanted to put that out there, that I will show you when I'm reading them, but I don't want to be, certainly don't want to be your only resource for that. Oh, I did give that 5 stars, by the way. Next, I read State of Wonder by Ann Patchett. And again, I read this for the Stephen King video, so you can pop over there to see what I thought. Then I read another play. I'm doing so much better at reading plays, you guys. Aren't you proud? Give me a little pat. Cyrano de Bergerac by Edmund Rostand. I reread this and you guys, I sobbed. I truly, for the last full 2 scenes of this play, I sat on my couch and wept like a baby, nonstop, tears streaming down my face, truly heaving sobs. I love this play with my whole heart. This might be my favorite play in the whole world. The other contender would be Angels in America, but this one, I love this play. If you haven't read it or seen it, please, please, please read it. It's so good. Don't let it scare you that it's like an old play. It's so funny and smart and heartwarming and then heartbreaking, and I love this book. So yeah, obviously 5 stars, all-time favorite. Next, I read I Am Watching You by Teresa Driscoll. This is a thriller, obviously, as you may have gathered. This book is about a woman on a train to London who overhears a conversation with 2 young teenage girls and 2 recently released convicts, and she, as a mother herself, becomes concerned for the safety of these 2 girls, but she doesn't do anything about it. She finds out later that week that 1 of the 2 girls went missing. And things get creepy from there. I really liked this. I thought that this was a really solid thriller. Honestly, I like saw the cover to this and I was like, this is gonna be bad. And I didn't really want to read it, but then I did. And it turned out to be pretty great, so don't judge a book by its cover, as they say. I ended up giving it 4 stars. Next, I read My Story by Elizabeth Smart. This is a survivor's memoir. She survived a horrible, horrible crime where this man and his wife kidnapped her and held her captive for nearly 9 months, and then she escaped and has moved on with her life, but she tells the story of her time in captivity, and it's really powerful. I don't want to give this a rating because it's such a, I would just feel so gross rating this, but it's really excellent. Then I read The Dancing Girls by M.M. Chouinard. I picked this up at the little free library down the street. I knew nothing about it. And it was a fun thriller. It was not an incredible thriller. It was kind of gimmicky, but it wasn't awful. Like, the writing was pretty good and the story was pretty engaging. And I wanted to know what happened, so I read the whole thing. Will I pick up another book in this series? Probably not, but it was definitely fun. I ended up giving it 3.5 stars. Then I read a play on New Play Exchange, which is, I believe I've talked about it before, but it's basically an online database where if you're a playwright, you can upload your plays, and then playwrights or directors or actors or whatever can read the plays. So I've been trying to read more plays off of there, and I read this play called In His Hands, or The Gay Christian Play by Benjamin Benn. It was just breathtaking from start to finish. The author deals with this really difficult topic, and he deals with it in such a beautiful, poetic way. In my, like, written review, I described it as poetry of the mundane. I don't know how to describe it, but that really interesting poem of just super mundane tasks paired with this really deep, complicated, emotional, spiritual conversation was phenomenal. So if you have access to New Play Exchange and are interested in reading new plays, I would super recommend checking that out. It was lovely. Then I read another play off of New Play Exchange called Washer Dryer by Nandita Shenoy. This play is basically about this couple who recently eloped, and now they are living in her studio apartment in New York and dealing with the difficulties of marriage. It's a, like, rom-com. It's really fun. I would say it wasn't, like, remarkable, but it was certainly fun. That's kind of all I have to say about that. I liked it, but, like, it didn't blow me out of the water. I gave it 3.5 stars. Then I read Franny and Zoe by J.D. Salinger. This book was so good. My friend Fallon sent this to me in the mail for all of us who live in this apartment to read, actually. But I got to it first because I was in the middle of, like, a reading rampage when she sent this. And this is so good. I loved this, and I was surprised that I loved it because I'm not a big fan of Catcher in the Rye, which is the super famous J.D. Salinger, but this was so clever and funny and, like, sarcastic and, like, ooh, I loved it. Would definitely read again. This makes me feel, like, all, like, deep and poetic and cool, so I gave it 5 stars. So next I read Displacement by Kiku Hughes. I actually read this because a friend of ours lent it to Devin, my roommate, who is half Japanese, for her to read, and then I also kind of snagged it, and Devin loved this. I'll just throw her quick review in here as well so that you know she highly recommends it. But this book is basically about this half Japanese girl trying to learn about her past and the Japanese-American internment camps that her ancestors were imprisoned in. Oh, it's a graphic novel, if that wasn't clear. I did not say that. It's a graphic novel. The artwork is really beautiful. I really enjoy the artwork. It definitely seems to be geared towards a younger audience, maybe like junior high, early high school maybe, but it's a really nice story that touches on the history of this time period. And it's definitely something that we should all learn more about. And this isn't gonna, like, teach you everything you need to know about it, but it's a great starting point. And a very quick read, obviously, because, you know, graphic novel, super fast. Oh, it comes out in August, so it should be coming out anytime now. But yeah, if this interests you, check it out. I liked it a lot. I think I gave it 4.5 stars. The last book I read is The Dinner by Herman Koch. And I'm actually not going to talk much about this because I'm reading it for an upcoming video. Wink, wink. Maybe you can guess what I'm reading that for. I'm sorry, this video has become really, really long. But thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. And I hope that you found something in this massive stack that interests you. And please like, subscribe, comment down below what you thought of any of these books if you've read them. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye. Mwah. Now I was headed to the bus stop, Maddie. You were